Hey, welcome to the Center Sportsman. I'm your host, Scott Lockoff. Today we're fishing in the Sunbury area, the Susquehanna River. We're going to try to get the early morning walleye bite. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
Help you catch more fish.
It's guaranteed.
I'm Scott Lockoff, host of the Center Sportsman. Check us out on the web, centersportsman.com. I'm glad Harry gave me a call and said, Scott, get down here, the walleyes are really biting. And I always wanted to fish the Sunbury area of the Susquehanna River. I heard it was really fantastic walleye fishing. I actually didn't realize how good it was. So we waited till it was, looked like it was gonna rain. You know, you want to fish for walleyes in the low light conditions. You don't want to go out there on a real bright sunny day. And also, this time of year, which is November, you want to wait till the water cools down. So they go on their feeding frenzy. They got to eat before the winter sets in, so they build up, store energy.
I'll tell you what we're doing is we're basically searching for them right now.
Yep.
See, I got the trolling motor down. I'm able to work up current a little bit. Throw out across the current, let it swing around the back of the boat a lot of times. That's the best way to find them. Is move around a little bit. Once you find them, then we can drop anchor and kind of slip the current a little bit and work the school.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. Sounds like a good game plan.
We got to catch one.
We got to catch one, yes. Gotta keep adjusting. Let the fish tell you what they want to do.
Here's what I like to do is I like to anchor off.
Yeah.
We'll fish a little section. And if we don't do anything, I'll pull that anchor up a little bit to slip us back to current.
Uh-huh.
3-4 feet. Now you're in a whole new strike zone.
Right.
So it's an efficient way to work a hole. And these walleye be specifically located in an area on a rock pond. So a lot of times people drift too fast.
Yeah, get down through them.
Yeah, so I just like to work it real slow. And
cast down there behind you.
And it's almost like drifting bait for trout. You know, just letting the current take it, and every once in a while I just snap my rod tip a little bit. A walleye can't take that. It's sitting there over top of her head. It's kind of like a fly on their nose, you know. Every once in a while you just jerk it a little bit. No. What I like to do is I just like to let it sit out there in the current.
Twitch it a little bit.
And just let it, that current's making that bait just move real slow.
Okay.
Nope. And then I just like to pull it up current a little bit. Do you have one on?
Oh, he got off. Oh, he got off.
Now, you can't horse. It's not a bass. You can't horse him like a bass, okay? It's like fighting a log.
Yeah, I was ripping his lip. Yeah. Oh, he popped it.
Okay.
I had him on for a second or two.
Don't get excited.
I'll calm down. Oh, I love walleye fishing.
Yeah.
Oh, I love walleye fishing.
Yeah, no, no horseback one. What's happening a lot of times, they're just coming up and mouthing it.
Okay.
So if you really rip them,
they'll pull
right
out.
And you start pulling. Just once you hook up with them,
I'll check.
Let the current and everything do the work for you.
All right. Well, he was on there for a second.
I don't know. I look like a guide bike to me.
The hooks are still there.
Right.
See, Harry, there are hooks on that. I thought maybe Dave the cameraman took my hooks off there for a minute, but now he did.
I see your rod go down.
Yeah, he's out there. Let's try it again.
Okay, what I'm going to do, since we haven't gotten a whole lot of bites right here,
I'll
show you what I do. I'm just going to loosen my rope.
Ah.
Drop a couple feet out.
Okay, now we're gonna work
drift
another
back.
Section.
Just 3-4 feet. That's all you got to drift back. It'll put you in a whole new strike zone. There's one.
All right.
It's just a small one.
Hey, there.
Huh?
A little one.
Yeah. What up?
Yeah, the big mama was underneath that one waiting for a morsel.
I'm Scott Locko, host of the Center Sportsman. Check us out on the web, centersportsman.com.
And a walleye is a finicky fish, so you sort of take a little pride in figuring them out and how to get them to bite. And that's always a challenge. It took us a little while to find them. But once we figured out how they were positioning themselves in the water, below the ripples, and the ripples below the spillway, the fiber dam is what they call it there, then we started catching walleyes, and boy, did we catch them.
A lot of times when I'm fishing, jerkbait down here, depending on the water depth.
Uh-huh.
You know, well, I might be using some suspended dots or whatever to
get
down there a little bit. Right now, the water's down, it's a little clear, so I'm just fishing a regular suspended jerkbait without adding any weight to it.
Okay.
White tips. Yeah. Not quite a legal walleye.
What do they have to be?
They have to be 15 inches.
15? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Not quite legal.
Hopefully we can get a couple bigger. We want your mama.
Yeah. Look at them teeth on those things.
Yeah, I think that's what they're just.
Susquehanna salmon.
Salmon, there you
go. There you go.
Yep.
Well, that was two hits right here in this one little hole. Right
yeah.
Here. That's a little better. It's a little better fish.
Get my lower out of the way.
Uh-huh. Eh, not quite, but he's getting there.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, there you go.
There we moved around 3 or 4 times, and we just happened to move to the right spot, you know?
Yeah.
That's a male, pretty much. It's probably a male walleye when they're about that shape. Those females, you can really tell them because their belly's a lot larger. They're carrying eggs this time of year. But that goes to show
that they're here.
You just move around a little bit. You find the.
Make a little adjustments every now and then when you have to.
fill measure. Close that mouth.
Yeah, oh yeah.
He's legal. About 15 and a half, almost 16.
Yep.
Yep.
All right.
Yep. He whacked it. I didn't get the hook in. Yeah, well, I'll tell you what.
Color wall, I really believe it makes all the difference.
Yeah.
I just don't really go wrong with greens and oranges.
A little chartreuse sometimes.
A little chartreuse.
Something
but I just like any type of a jerk bait, green,
okay.
Orange, especially an orange belly.
That's a good one.
Now don't horse him like a salmon now.
This is a nice one. Uh-huh. This is going. Stay on here. Stay on. Right. Boy, they turn sideways in that current.
Yeah. And I'll get the net when you get closer to the boat.
Okay. Oh, yeah, look at the side of this thing.
Nice one.
Some shoulders on him.
Uh-huh. Let me get back up here in the troller motor.
Yep, get the troller motor. Keep us in that spot, Harry.
Good job, Harry. Uh-huh.
Yeah, this is a nice eating size. We want to stress to throw the females back, the big spawners. You don't want to kill them.
Pretty much anything over 20 inches, Scotty, it's going back in, you know.
So we keep the walleye population.
Especially high. Anything 22 and above. Got to think conservation.
Yep.
And besides, the smaller walleye that size right there is the much better eating fish. You know.
Yep. All right, I'm happy now. That walleye ripped the hook out of that. No. I think Harry had caught a lot of walleyes on this one. Oh.
We've been out here about an hour.
Oh, yeah.
And it took us about half an hour to find them. Once we did, look what's happened.
Yep.
They're just
bam, bam.
One right after another.
Oh, yeah. You got her down to a science, Harry.
See, there's another 15 and a half to 16 inch walleye, and that's the perfect size for eating to me.
I'm Scott Lockoff, host of the Center Sportsman. Check us out on the web, centersportsman.com.
Straight in.
Right there.
Oh, yeah. share a little trick I use. Okay, just drop your rod tip. When I first throw it, I like to put my rod tip down, jerk it two times to get it down, then slowly lift it up.
Okay.
That gets that suspended bait down
to where it's
and then
supposed to work.
Then it's sitting there, and I have a little bit more drag on it.
Okay. Get one, Eric.
Start, just like I said.
Yep.
A double.
Yeah, he whacked that thing. There he is. There he is. Huh? Yeah. There's a double. Harry, you're a genius.
Well, that's a good fish.
mine might be a little short.
I don't know. That's
close.
Hey, yeah. Any day.
That's a keeper there. Right?
Any day that you can get
double. Yeah. No, it was fun. That goes to show you get in the right spot.
Well, we were over there again. That our baits. Well, yours was kind of out the back of the boat.
Yeah, mine was out.
Mine was coming across current.
Coming across and swinging around. Coming up.
Is he coming
up? I think
he's. No. I don't know yet. Here, let's see. No, that looks like a walleye.
That's
looks
a
like
walleye.
A nice walleye.
Yeah, that's a nice one. Yep.
Oh, yes. Give me the honor, huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, he's right on tail end. Oh, yeah. You can't get any better size for eating.
No, that's
right
perfect.
There.
That's perfect.
That's perfect. Yep.
That's a perfect size there. Mm-hmm. Oh, be careful. They have a sharp gill plate.
Mm-hmm.
See that bone protruding? That's sharp as a razor.
Yep, that'll cut you.
Yeah, I remember tossing one back one time, slicing my hand. So you gotta be careful about with the teeth and that gill plate. The filet mignon of the freshwater fish. Another walleye goes in the live well. And we're not gonna do this every day, just one fish fry, that's good. You know, just to try it. Dave the cameraman, never had walleye. I've been bragging how good they are, so we're gonna find out.
Did you see how I dropped my rod tip back?
Yep.
And when I jerked it back up, that's when he hit
Bang.
It.
Sunbury area for my good buddy Harry Ward. He definitely knows what he's talking about.
Oh, that feels like a pretty good one, Scotty.
All right.
I'm doing is letting that anchor come out like 2 feet. And what happens is now you're in a whole new strike zone area. And I'm just gonna
keep doing that fan, the whole way down.
Just keep fan casting this hole. The idea is not to work the hole too fast.
Just like that. Just like that.
Boy, he's popping.
Oh, that's definitely a keeper. Woo.
I mean, that is the perfect eating size walleye right there.
Hey, Harry, geez, thanks.
You're welcome.
Sure had a great day catching some walleyes. Thanks for
giving you a good day on the water down here on the Susquehanna River.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Hey, thanks again, Harry.
Okay.
Sure was a great time.
Have a good one.